This first song is, it's one I wanted to sing here, and I couldn't really, I don't know, I was kind of waiting for a theme, and like I missed, I don't know, I could have fit into a Valentine's kind of theme stuff, so, but it didn't really fit into anything that's come up that I could think of, but I've been wanting to sing it, so when you said, are there any stories, I thought, well, this song is a bit of a story, but, the first line, I'll tell you what the first line is. So, sometimes I get sad, you know, and, you know, everybody gets sad from time to time, but, you know, I'm one of those people who get sad for periods of time. And one time I felt, I could feel the sadness coming, like, and it was here, and I said this, and I, you know, to myself, well, I said it out loud, but I was the only one there. But I said, saddle up my sorrow, I'm going for a ride.
Nice.
And it's like, here we go, okay. You know, and then, I liked that line. Yeah, I thought, oh, that was a good line, you know, and that's, you know, a lot of artists come to creativity through some sort of emotional turmoil. I mean, where would we be without it, really? So I liked that line, and then I ended up writing this song about it, and the song is more about like this sort of love that's been lost, and like it's time to go out and just bury it, you know, like lay your love to rest is what the song is called. And then, but I realized afterwards that. And this is the funny thing about songs and writing in general, is a lot of times you write these things, you don't really know what they mean or what it's trying to tell you. But one of the things I think that this is saying also is that it's not just about the love, but it's also about sadness, or it's about guilt, and it's about letting go. It's about taking those things and saying sometimes it's just, you gotta let it go. Anyways, here we go.
Sometimes you gotta kill yesterday.
for tomorrow's good. 'Cause some loves are like horses, in the end it's for the best. You got to shoot them limping memories and lay your love to rest. You've got to lay your love to rest. You've got to lay your love to rest. Gotta untie all them heartstrings, pull her from your chest. You've got to bury all those memories and lay your love to rest. Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today to pay our respects to a love that's passed away. Rest in peace. R.I.P. Remembrance is pain. R.I.P. Release it, please. R.I.P. Release it, please. You've got to lay your love to rest.
That was great. Don't have to see my therapist this week.
They'll still charge me.
That's right.
The man who knows therapists here, man.
That's right. So I've got a couple other songs for you. This one, this is a song that I started. It's not that, like, this part of the story isn't really interesting, but, like, I started it 5 years ago, and I just had it about three-quarters done for the ages, and then it finally, it's one of those things that's like, oh man, there's gotta be I gotta finish this song. And, finally, I did, so, and this is called Unspoken. And this is another love song. So the other one's about like a love that's finished, and you're saying goodbye to this love that's finished. Whereas this one is about before the love starts and when you haven't even told the person how you feel. And I recently played this. I was invited over to Jonna Slaby's art exhibition opening, and it was her first art exhibition, and so I sang this song with another level of meaning, being that, you know, not only can love not be spoken, but if you have this art, if you have this creativity inside of you, you need to speak it, you need to put it out there, because otherwise leaving it unspoken really sucks.
Dead transmission that Unspoken, it's good for the flame. Tell your stories, speak it out. So now that I got you all in a good mood, I thought I'd end with a happy, happy song. And a happy story. This is the first time I was in Japan when I was in, so I was in my, I guess at the time I would have been maybe my mid to late 20s. And I was working for the Board of Education, and it was the early years of the JET program, and my job was to go around and check on all the teachers, and so I got to just go and make sure everybody's doing all right. I didn't really have to teach very much, but I did get, I got the sort of special schools. And one of the special schools was the School of Forestry, so I'd go up to the, in the woods where the kids were studying forestry, and They were probably some of the toughest students I've ever had to teach. I don't know why. Been out in the woods and they go a bit nuts up there. But I also had the amazing, I don't know, I guess my job was to go and visit the school for the deaf and the school for the blind. And I got to teach them English, you know, and I know that I remember the first day when I was teaching the deaf students, and I thought, how are we doing this? Basically, I just speak English and they're signing in Japanese so that they're translating it. And then the students were speaking back to me in English, you know, as best they could, and it was amazing. But I was teaching at the school for the blind, and I thought, you know, the nice thing about going there was that I could kind of do whatever I wanted, and let's find something that it's going to really kind of connect with the students. So I brought in my guitar. And I said, you know, and we had our 50-minute period. And I said, okay, we're going to write a song. We're going to write an English song today. So, what are your favorite English words? And I was just like, I hope this is all going to come together. Okay, all right, what's your favorite English words? And the first word that the first kid said was window. Window. It's his favorite English word. And my heart just was like, oh. Next one, what about you? What's your favorite English word? Sky.
Okay.
I get goosebumps just telling that. So we had window, we had sky, mountain, sea, and then, that's right, I swear it was the last kid. And what about you? What's your favorite English word? And everybody else is all so tangible. And he goes, Gloria. Gloria. Yeah, all right. All right, we can do this. We can make a song out of this. So, we made a song, and for the, I'm going to sing it slowly, and you can help me with it, because basically the way that we had to do it is, like, I sang parts of it, and then they would repeat, like, the word, you know, the one part of the word. So it was like, so it went kind of like this, and just, this is going to go down great. You heard this song before. I see the sky. Look out my window. I see the sea. I see mountains rising high. I see valleys.
You.
Look in my verse is even easier because it's just the first verse again. So now that you know how it goes, I'd like you all to sing it with me. But I'd like you to close your eyes.
All right.
And I will too, and hopefully I won't put my teeth into the microphone, but here we go.
And there were there was our tough. There was a guy and a girl there in front of the school, and they were blind, and they were in love. How they connected, I have no idea. But they were standing there, there was no one around. And they were in love. She said, "You did this." And I just had to say, they were like two unlit candles standing there in love. Just all over their faces. It was beautiful. Very much, I forgot about that. That's 25, 30 years ago that happened. Because they were there, just alone. Now, thanks to you again, not next month, there's no plan next month, but the month after that, the theme will be unspoken.
Oh.
Okay, something unspoken, unsaid, things we would like to have. Is that a good theme? That's it for September. So please join in if you can. I know there are people here who already have ideas for that. Thank you. That's
all
for tonight.
You had a good song.
You can open the evening next time instead of closing it. You open the evening. Thank you very much. This was a beautiful, intimate night, and I appreciate your coming.
Yes, it is. Very nice.